Hi friends, so let us discuss test number 18 today. Come on, see first question. How many such pairs of letters are there in the organized, each of which has as many letters between them in the word as in the English alphabet? Right, see, now when you look at here directly, we can say, see, when you start with the first letter O, the remaining letters are not matching. R is the biggest letter, the other letters are not matching. See, even with the G, you don't get. Yeah, now see A, with A you'll get A, B, C, D, E. A, E are matching, and in the reverse order, D, E are matching. See, only two pairs are there, A, E and D, E. So answer is 31st question, third option. Come on, question 32. Among P, Q, R, S and T, each having different marks, okay? P scored more than P and T, Q scored less marks than T, S did not score the highest marks. P did not score the least mark. Who among them scored the least? Right, come on. So, if you take here, see, R scored more marks. So, first of all, let us put like this. R scored more marks than, what is given there? P and T. Okay. Q scored less marks than T. So, let us put it like this. Q scored less marks than T. S did not score the highest mark. Right. So, S did not score the highest mark. P did not score the least mark. P did not score the least mark. Total 5 persons are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Then, what P did not score the least mark. Then, who among them scored the least? Who scored the least? Naturally, we think that Q scored the least. But please note, we don't know. Either Q or S. Understood? Because S did not score the highest mark. Means, we don't know what kind of, what mark, how many marks S has got. So, it should be either S or Q. So, answer is 4th option. 32, 4th option. Right. Come on, 33. In a row of 25 children facing north, W is 5th to the right of R, who is 16th from the right. See, R is 16th from the right. So, when you take here, W is 5th to the right of R, 5th. So, 16 minus 5, 11th. So, W is 11th from the right. Okay. What is W's position from the left end? So, total 20 are there. So, we know 20 plus 1. So, it should be 20 from the left end. Understood? 21. So, this is 10. 10 from the left hand, because 21 should be n plus 1. So, 25 are there, right? So, 25. So, that is the reason 25 is 26. It should be 15th. So, answer is 15th, first option. 33, first option. 34. If CA, CGA in one sequence following a logic and another four letter sequence following similar type of logic is FJDI. Come on, find out. See, CGAI. Whenever they give you like this, you have to convert the letters into numbers. See, 3, 7, 1, this is 9. So, minus 4, sorry, plus 4, minus 6, plus 8. Okay. In the same way, you take next one. FJDL. See, F6, J10, D6, so L, 12. So, even that has got the same logic. So, the based on that, answer is second option. You take second option. What is given? HL, FN. See, this is 8, this is 12, this is 6, this is 14. Okay. See, minus 4 plus 6. See, plus 4 minus 6 plus 8. So, answer is second option. 34, second option. 35. Yeah, this think logically and tell me the answer. A disease would always necessarily have. See, whenever a person is affected with a disease, means there should be some cause. Cause must be there. So, answer is cause. 35, third option. 36. Yeah, see, there's a series, letter series. Right. So, when they give you like this, observe the first letter. See, whenever they give you like this, observe the first letter. See how they give? Z, Y, W, V, U, S, R, Q, O. Okay, leave this. Come on, Z. See, now this is 26. This is 22. So, this is 18. So, it should be 14. Okay. Minus 4, minus 4, minus 4. In the same way, 25, 21, 17, 13. Okay, 23, 19, 15. Okay, 19, 15, 11. So this is NMK. NMK. So NMK answer is 36, fourth option. Come on, 37 to 40. Right. See, now they're discussing about 20 students are standing in a straight line facing north. Right. Come on, let us put it. Yeah. Now see, what they say. See, they're discussing about Meena standing six from the left end. There are only three students between Meena and Shweta. See, between means we know that there are two possibilities. Now see, all the data is connected. Radha stand exactly between Shweta and Meena. So let us take two possibilities now, because unless you take two possibilities, of course, we can eliminate one possibility based on the last line. You see, if you take here, they say that there are more than four students between Meena and Tina. So based on that point, we can eliminate one option. Come on, let us verify. So if you take, see, sixth Meena, then Shweta, 10, okay. And if you take Radha, exactly between 8th. Now if you take other possibility, Meena is 6th, Shweta, okay, I'll put like this, Shweta is 2nd, because difference is 3 means, see, between 3 means difference should be 4, so 6 plus 4, 6 minus 4, here between 8, so it should be here 4, so this is Radha. Okay, now if they say Tina is standing 6 to the right of Radha, 6th, so 8 plus 6, 14. In the same way here, 4 plus 6, 10. This is Tina. Okay. Next, they say that, see, then what is given? Last statement. See, Amita is standing 4th from the right end. Right. 4th from right, let us put like this. Okay, right. Come on, see first one. How many people are standing? See, please note. Now we have to focus on the point. There are more than four students between Meena and Tina. There are more than four students between Meena and Tina. See, this is correct. Because here, if you take what is given, Meena and Tina. See, this is Meena, right? Here only three students are there. So please note, this possibility is correct. This is wrong. Okay, right. See, now first one. How many people standing between Anita and Tina? So Anita is here, Tina is there. How many standing? See, we know the total 20 are there. So 20 means when you take Tina's rank, 21 minus 14, 7th. So 7th from right, 4th from right. Difference is 3. So two persons are there between. So 37, second option. 38. What is Sweta's position with respect to Anita? Right. See, 10 from the left means from the right it is 11. 11 from the right. Fourth, 11. That means 7. 7th to the left. So 38, third option. If Kiran is exactly between Radha and Tina. Kiran is exactly between Radha and Tina. So simple, what do you have to do? Add both the things. 8 plus 14, 22. 22 by 2, that is equal to 11th. Understood? So please note, 11th position is Kiran from the left. Okay, 11th from the left. Okay, then what is position from the right end? See, if it's 11th from the left, his position is 10th from the right. Because 11 plus 10, so 10th from the right. Here, 4th from the right. So, 6th to the left. See, what is asked in the question? What is position from the right end? That is 10th. So, 39th, 4th option. If there are only 3 persons between Meena and Tina. See, now they are discussing about this. If there are only 3 persons between Meena and Tina. See, if that is the case, say they are ignoring the original one. Now they are talking about this. If there are only 3 persons between Meena and Tina, what is Sweta's position with respect to Anita? See, second from the left, so automatically she is 19th from the right. So 19th from the right, 4th from the right, difference is 15. So 15 to the left. So answer is 40th question, third option. Okay, 40th question, fourth option, third option, sorry. Right, now come to, see, 41 to 45, okay? Right, so they are discussing about circular seating arrangement. Yeah, circular seating arrangement, so total 8 persons are there. So what are the important points? O is sitting third to the right of M. So let us put like this, O is sitting third to the right of M, okay? There is only one person between M and J. M and J, say I am taking the connecting points, okay? Next, now is again connected to J. There are 3 points between J and K. 3 persons between J and K. P is an immediate neighbor of J, okay? P is immediate neighbor of J. There are only 3 persons between P and L. P and L, N is second to the right of P. N is second to the right of P. Right, okay, come on. Now, see, O is connected to M, J, all are connecting statements. So, first of all, let us put like this. Okay, now let us take this point. O is third to the right of M. If I take M like this, first right, second right, third right, O is here. There is one person between M and J. But please note, here where is, whether J is here or here, we don't know. So now let us take possibilities to work it out. Say I have taken one like this, now I am taking another possibility here. Okay, M, O, J. There are 3 persons between J and K. So 3 persons means, simple, both are opposite to each other. So K is here, here K is there. Okay, now P is immediate neighbor of J. There are 3 persons between P and L. Now please understand. See, P is immediate neighbor of J. If I take P here, okay, so this should be L. Here, I cannot take P here because there are 3 persons between P and L. So P should be here, L should be here. Now, next point, N is second to the right of P. See, N is second to the right of P. Right, N is second to the right of P. Here you don't get. So please note, this is wrong, this is correct. So we have got all the persons. Who is the other person now? Q. Okay. So in this way, whenever you get a question on seating arrangement, see, generally in exam, they're going to ask you questions which are so logical, so tricky. They don't complicate the issues. Okay, complexity is not at all involved in the question. So that is the reason what you do whenever they give you like this, you try to explore the possibilities and try to eliminate the possibilities. Understood? Right, come on. See, first one, 41st question. Which are the following is true regarding the given arrangement? M is an immediate, that is wrong. N is immediate neighbor of J. Yeah, that is correct. So 41st, second option. 42. Who is sitting second to the left of the, who is sitting second to the left of Q? Okay. Second to the left of Q, K, second to the left of K is M. So answer is 42nd, first option. 43. 4 of the following 5 are similar in a certain way. Okay, come on. PQ. P is immediate right of Q. Okay. Next, KL. K is immediate right of L. K is immediate right of L. MN. M is immediate right of N. QO. Yeah, Q is immediate right of O, but you take KO, K is immediate left of O. So answer is 43, fifth option, because in all the cases, first person is immediate right of second person. Come on, 44. What is N's position with respect to K? What is N's position with respect to K? First left, second left, third left. Okay, third left. So 44, third option. 45. How many people are sitting between K and P? K and P, when counted from the right side of K, right side of K, O and, so 2 persons are there. So 45th, second option. Right, come to next question, 46 to 52. Right, so please note, there's a puzzle test, a classification model. Because they're discussing about people who are traveling to different cities or towns, I can say. Dif- different places. Okay, so seven persons are there. Each one traveled in different months. So please note that, see, each one traveled different months. And it's given from January and ending in July. So sequential model puzzle test. So whenever a question is given in sequential, we have to go take the sequence and try to work it out. Okay, so give importance to that. So come on. So let us put like this. See, Jan, Feb, March, April, May, June, July, okay? So person, place, let us put like this, yeah. Now see the important points now. See, only four friends traveled between the one who traveled to Vishakhapatnam and the one who traveled to Hyderabad. So let us put like this. See, Vizag, four persons to Hyderabad. Alright, so between. So again, there are two possibilities. So we have to see. Next, the person who traveled to Vishakhapatnam did not travel month of June. So please note, Vishakhapatnam person did not come in the month, did not travel in the month of June. Only one person traveled between the one who traveled to Vishakhapatnam and the one traveled to Bangalore. So please note again, Vishakhapatnam 1, Bangalore. Right. Okay. The person who traveled was, whose travel was scheduled to Chennai was immediately after the one who traveled to Vishakhapatnam. So please note, if you take Vizag, after that, the person who traveled to Chennai was scheduled. Okay. Chennai was scheduled. Next, the person who visited Anantapur was immediately before the person who traveled to Guntur. Right. So, Anantapur. So, I'll just put like this. Anant and Guntur. Okay. The person who traveled to Guntur was not in the month of May. So, Guntur. Not in the month of May. Okay, the person who traveled not in the month of May, B traveled in the month which has 31 days. So B is here or here or here or here. Right, okay. Yeah, G's travel was immediately preceded by that of D. So please note like this, D, G and followed, immediately followed by F. So D, G, F. Okay, G's travel, okay, right, followed by G did not travel in the month of May. So G did not travel in the month of May. So let us put like this. G did not travel. Yeah. C did not travel to Bangalore. C did not travel to Bangalore. Okay. Now, see, when you take the data like this, see, after Vizag, the Chennai travel has to come. Okay. Chennai person travel. So, from this, see, you can't take Vizag here because four persons. So, we can't take like this. I can't take Vizag here because Vizag is not possible here. So that means, see, Vizag, the person who traveled Vizag cannot be in the month of June or July, okay? Because you see that there are four, they've given you, four persons traveled between, these two people traveled between Vizag and Hyderabad. So Vizag cannot come here, so we have to try from here. So now again, where to take it? So let us take possibilities, okay? Say for example, I've taken Vizag here, okay? So 1, 2, 3, 4, okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, this comes Hyderabad. In the same, if you take Vizag here, please note, 1, 2, 3, 4, it comes Hyderabad. Now after Vizag, Chennai. So Chennai comes here. Okay, this is Chennai. Okay, now between Vizag and Bangalore, one person is there. Understood? So please note Bangalore. This is Bangalore. Okay, so this is Bangalore. Right. Now based on the data, say Anantapur, Guntur, this should be sequential. So it has to be like this. So Anant, Guntur, but please see, this is not possible. Okay, so please note this is wrong. So definitely it should be correct. So please note Anantapur, this is Guntur. Okay, now other place is Mumbai. So Mumbai comes here. Mumbai comes here. Clear? Now, as per the data, see, it has to be like this. Now, in the data clearly given that, see, what is given? C did not travel to Bangalore. Next. See, he traveled in the month of March. He traveled in the month of March. So, let us put like this E, okay? He traveled in the month of March. Now, when you take this data, see, it cannot come here. It has to be here. Now, G cannot be here, okay? So, G cannot be here. So, definitely, we have to take the data like this. D, G, F. Understood? D, G, F. So, when you take like this, you take B. B traveled in the month which has 31 days. Here already March, E is there. May, July, already it's here D and F are there. So automatically this person should be B. Okay. Now in the data, as per the data, C did not travel to Bangalore. Right, okay. Then you take G did not travel in the month of May. Right. So based on that, now if you take C will come here, A comes here. So B, C, E, A, D, G, F. Okay? So this is correct. Yeah, come on. Which are the following places C traveled? C will travel to Vizag. So let us not get confused. This is wrong. Okay? Strike it off. Vishakhapatnam. Okay? 46th second option. 47. How many persons traveled between the one who traveled to Mumbai and the one who traveled to Chennai? Mumbai, Chennai, one person. So 47, first option. 48. Which of the following statements to regarding according to the given sequence? B traveled in July, wrong. C traveled in April, wrong, okay. Then G traveled in May, wrong. C traveled in January, that is also wrong. C traveled in January, fourth option, that's also wrong. Answer is fifth option, none is true. 48. 49. Four of the following five are in a similar way, right? See January, Vishakhapatnam. See January, next person's travel. January, Vishakhapatnam, like this, okay? This way. Okay, next in the same way, March, Bangalore. Then June Hyderabad, right? Okay, you take which one? May Anantapur, it's not, see, straight. So that's not correct. So answer is that's not matching. February Chennai, okay. So 49th, fourth option. 50, okay, say 50, 51. Yeah, come on, 50th. Which of the following cities he traveled in the month of March? He traveled, where? Chennai. So 50th question, fourth option. 51. The person who traveled Mumbai was which of the months? January. So that is not given. So 51, fifth option. Which of the following places G traveled to Guntur. So 52nd, fourth option. Right. Yeah, now come to 53 to 55. Yeah, it's a comparison model puzzle test. Okay, comparison model puzzle test. So total six friends are there. Okay, total six friends are there. Now see, each of them has a different weight. So they're talking about the comparison of weights. Yeah, see, now the important point, see, Arun's weight is more than, come on, let us put it here. You take Anu. Anu weight is more than Saurabh, okay? But less than Soumya, okay? Only one person is heavier than Sushant. So please understand, only one person is heavier than Sushant. So that means this person who is heavier than Sushant is the heaviest. So please note, this person is heaviest, and we can definitely say Sushant is second heaviest based on the word called only. Okay, based on the word called only. Okay, now total six persons are there. See, now how many got? 1, 2, so 3, 4, 5 other person, right? Now Swati, see, now next point, Swati is not the heaviest. See, Soumya is not the heaviest. Of course, Soumya is not the heaviest, right? Swati is not heavier than Saurabh. Swati is not heavier than Saurabh, so Swati should be here, okay? Swati. Now it's clear, total 6 persons are there. So Swati, Saurabh, Anu, Soumya, then Sushant, other person is Raman. So Raman comes here. So like this. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so this person is lightest. Yeah, 53. Whose weight is second heaviest? Sushant. So, 53rd, third option. 54. If Sushant is 8 kilos heavier than Anu, see in the data, they gave you that, the one whose weight is second heaviest, so second heaviest, 46 kilos. Okay, then Sushant, Sushant is 58, right? Now see, as per the question now, if Sushant is 8 kgs heavier than Anu, okay? If Sushant is 8 kgs heavier than Anu, means Anu's weight will be 50, right? Then what is the possible weight of Soumya? So definitely Soumya's weight should be between 50 and 58. So you have to go based on the options. Right answer is third option, 55 kilos or 54, third option. Which of the following statement is true? Raman's weight is, that is wrong. Swati is heavier, that is wrong. Raman is the heaviest, that is correct. Understood? So 55, third option. Come on, 56 to 62. Yeah, 56 to 62. See, again, that's based on a circular seating arrangement. Yeah, total 8 persons are there. Okay, O, P, Q, R, Z, T, U, and V. Right, now let us first of all see the points which are connecting points. P is second to the left of U. V is third to the left of, V is third to the left of T, okay. O is not, see, important point. O is not immediate neighbor of P or U. O is not immediate neighbor of P or U. So these points are connecting points. Right. Next, R is not immediate neighbor of T. So let us put like this. T. Okay. QV is the only one between O and R. QV is the only one between O and R. So there are two possibilities. Okay. Z is not immediate neighbor of P. Z is not immediate neighbor of. Now when look at the points, please note, this is better in case you take this point, because this point is connected to this, okay? Based on this, we can get this. Then based on this, we can find out, okay? So I think we have to take possibilities and work it out. So let us put the data now. So if I take like this, okay? So let us take, P is second to the left of U. P is second to the left of U. Okay, O is not immediate neighbor of P or U. So O cannot come here, O cannot come here, O cannot come here. So there are three possibilities. O can be anywhere. Now let us try possibility. Say for example, I have taken O here. Okay, so I have taken another possibility, O here. Okay, so this is U, this is P, and I have taken another possibility here. Okay, this is P, this is U, this is O. But please note, this is simple in case you take like this, because we can easily eliminate the options, okay? Right, now we know that three persons are there, okay? Now, okay, so let us take for example, if I take O here, see there are three, this one. So R can be here, or U can be, say Q, okay? So O, so let us take O here, O, this one O, okay? So O, so now R can be here, or Q can be here. In the same way, please note, R can be here, Q or R, this one. In the same way here, R, Q, R, okay? This will be Q. Q is between O and R. Q is between O and R. In the same way, if you take O is here, O, Q, R. So this person is Q, Q, R, okay? No, because in the data, they say Q is between O and R. Q is between O and R. So let us put like this. Okay. Right. Now, See, R is not even neighbor of T. Now take this point, V is third to the left of T. V is third to the left of T. Right, now take here, for example, third to the left of T. See, these three people are side by side, right? If you take T here, first left, second left, third, it's not possible. I cannot take T here. That means this is wrong. Clear? Now here, yeah, we can take like this. There's only one possibility. So V is third to the left of T. So if I take T here, first left, second left, third left, please note, V comes here. Now who is the other person now? Z comes here. But please note, this is wrong. P and Z cannot be adjacent to each other. So this is wrong. Okay? That is wrong. That means the thing is that you can't take like this. Now, as per the data, so we have to see here O. See, we have taken like this OQR. It is not coming. Okay, now let us try this one. If take here P is second to the left of U. Okay, Q we have taken. Now here, see, this is not possible again based on this point. V is third to the left of T. So now see, we have taken only one possibility here. Q is between O and R. Okay, but as per the data, okay, so let us take the like this. Okay, this way. Let us rub this. Okay, P is second to the left of U. Next, let us take O here. Then Q, this is R. Okay, based on this. Now we have to see based on this. Okay. O cannot come here, right? Now, V is third to the left of T. V is third to the left of T, so this is the only possibility. If you take T, first left, second left, third left, V comes here. And this is Z, Z comes here. Understood? So this is the only possibility. So please note, based on the point, V is third to the left of T, this is eliminated. This is eliminated because based on Z cannot be the neighbor of P. So this is the answer. Right. So R, Q, O, T, Z, U, V. Now see the options. Z and P are not immediate neighbors. R and T are not immediate neighbors. Right. Yeah. 56th. Whom the following is opposite Z? R. So 56 second option. Starting from O, if all the prints are made to sit in alphabetical order in clockwise. Right. If you take here, from here, see O. Yeah, then what they say, which will remain unchanged, which person will remain unchanged? See, O, P, Q, T, U, V, so it's not matching. So, every is none. So, every place changed. So, 57, third option. Who am the following sits third to the left of U? First left, second left, third left, R. So, 58, fourth option. Which of the following pairs are immediate neighbors of T? O and Z. Answer is 59, first option. 60th. If the places of O and V are interchanged, so O comes here, V comes here. Interchange. Who is third to the right of Q? O. So 60th, second option. Which of the following is true with respect to the given seating arrangement? O sits in mid right of Z, wrong. Second one, U is exactly V and P, that is wrong. Next, Z sits second right of V. Yeah, that is correct. So answer is third option. 61, third option. 62. If T is related to P, that is opposite to each other. Q is related to U, okay. In the same way, Z is related to R. So answer is 62, fifth option. Right. Now come to 63 to 65. See, 63 to 65, they're discussing on data sufficiency. Right. So they're giving you three statements. Based on that, you had to work it out. Yeah. See, first one, total six prints are there. They're talking about circular table facing the center. Now they're talking about, discussing about what is the position of S with respect to M. Now, when you look at the statements, in first statement, yes is not discussed. In second statement, neither M nor S are discussed. In the third statement, neither M nor S are discussed. So, even to take first statement, that's not sufficient. So, we have to combine. See, looking at that, we can definitely say that we have to combine all the statements to see whether it will get the answer. Now, see the options. See, in the options, you see, definitely we have to get the option, we have to get the answer based on the given options, because they say 1 and 2, 2 and 3, 3, 1 and 3, 1, 2 and 3. But logically speaking, until we combine all the statements, we may not be able to get. So let us combine. Come on. Now take, so total 6 persons are there. So put the data like this. Right. Which point we'll take? See, R is second to the left of W. Let us take that point. Okay. So I take W here. First left, second left, R is here. M is between R and T. So M is here. M is between R and T. Okay. U does not sit on the limit right of R. So U have to be, sir, U should be here. So yes. Okay. So we're able to get the answer based on combining all the three statements. Okay. What is the position of S with respect to M? So second right. So answer is combining all the statements. 63, fifth option. 64. What is the code for cold? Yeah, there's a simple bit. See, cold is given only in the first statement. But please note, we cannot find out based on the first statement. Now see, ice cream is, both are given in the first statement as well as in the third statement. So in that way, lick and lick and jick are common. So remove that. So we can say cold is equal to tick. So 64th, 1 and 3. So answer is 64, fourth option. 65. Among P, Q, R, S, T, U and U, whose rank is first in a class test? Right. Yeah. So 6 persons are there. So now take first point. P scored more than only R and S. See, more than only R and S. So from this we can say that this person comes in third rank, third position. From the bottom. Okay. So because 1, 2, 3 or 1, 2, 3 from bottom. So total 3 persons are there above. T's rank is third highest. So T rank is third highest. T. Or we can say from here this is 4. Third highest. Okay. So that means if you take here, we got P, S, R, T. Okay. 2 persons are missing. Okay. Who are they? Q and V. Q and U. U did not score the highest. So U did not the score highest means we can definitely say that Q scored the highest. Okay, so Q, U, T, P, these two people. So either R is the score the least, but we can definitely say Q scored the highest. So by combining all the statements, we are able to get the answer. So 65th question, 5th option. Okay, so I thank you very much.